Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kate. It's Whiskey Watch. Not Fino Vision, Whiskey Watch. I'm kind of branching out nowadays, isn't I? Listen, you got to bear with me because I kind of... I get little thoughts in my head now and again. And I kind of, I know a little bit about whiskies and wines and what have you. You know, beer's more my kind of thing that I'm into and that. But also, I love good whiskies and that. So, what have I got? I've got me whiskey sets and things here. Got me Jurors for Christmas, little one. Look at that, look, it's nice, isn't it? Little triple sets. I've got Brooke Luddy. I've got Bailey Nicole Jarvie. A few other bits and pieces. All on top of me little box and all my beers. It's my little stash. So I'm going to do a little Glenfiddich set here. Little 12, 15 and 18 single malt in the little bottles, and I kind of like the little bottles I do because I don't drink a lot. Occasionally I'll have like just a cheap old whiskies and things, and I'll have a little nip in my coffee, and sometimes see people that are the connoisseurs and stuff like that will go, what? I kind of put cinnamon sticks and things like that to a couple of cinnamon sticks inside the whiskey, just whoosh it round a little bit and let it steep for a little while, like a month or something like that, and then I use that in my coffee. Ooh, it's nice. But yeah, I know you're going to tell me off. And a little bit sometimes in my when I do porridge, I make it with the all grain porridge, what do I call it? Oat bran, that's it, oat bran porridge. I do that and a little bit of desiccated coconut in there. Mix it all up, that kind of sweetens it up a little bit, and then a little bit of me whiskey and cinnamon in there as well. And it's bloody lovely. Means I don't get no sugars and stuff. Right. I'm going to go for the 12. Start off kind of with the younger ones and work my way up with the, you know, older barrelings and that, older casks and what have you. Now this is a 12-year-old cask, this one. 12-year-old single malt whiskey. Glenfiddich. This is the biggest, I believe, maker of the single malts. So, there we go, a little top there, pops off, and inside you've got a little pretty little bottle, that's lovely, little kind of triangular bottle. If you see the shape there, look at that, isn't that pretty? Little funny triangular bottle, and these are in little tiny 5 mils, so I suppose that's, what's that, a measure, 2 measures, is that? I don't know. Anyway. I'm going to pour that out. I don't know whether I have a bit of water in this or not. I've got one out of there already and this is about half. So that's the colour in there. Let's stick a bit of a photo up behind that. There is what, let me tell you what I'm getting. I'm getting pretty much that, what you're seeing there. With a little hint of that yellow on the actual thingy here, the paper, but I'm mainly getting that where you're getting through the glass there. It's quite pretty. As far as legs and shit like that, let's have a look. It's hanging on. You can see that rim around the glass there, see it? It's not really getting massive amounts of stuff, but if you look, hanging on to the glass there, just hanging on there, making little smears and things on its way down. Little oils and that. The oils will separate out there. They're kind of holding on to the flavours and that. If you get kind of the unfiltered whiskies. In particular, this Brochladdy. You get something like that, you put a little bit of water in there carefully, you'll see it kind of, you have a little layer of oil that comes, rises up to the surface, and it really separates things out there. So I'm going to try that with this, just pour a little bit down the side here, just gentle one. I don't know if you'll see this. So it'll go kind of, those oils all move about and everything. And then you'll see, hopefully, don't keep me old shaky hand still. You may see anyway. See on the top there, those oils? See that little layer of oils on the top? All risen to the surface, yeah? Can you get that? All flavoursome oils. Now just twirl them in a little bit. All flavourful. All kind of doing their thing. The alcohol carries a lot of the aromas and stuff like that, and a lot of the tastes as well, a lot of the flavours. But also those oils will, and they separate out in water and kind of float up to the surface. And now you can see, now when I show you, you'll see a bit more of those legs, if I want to show you. Nope, can't see it. Yep, there they are. See them down the glass there? Like rain on your windscreen. It's pretty. Right, let's have a little nose. Excuse me, itching, I can hardly hear what I'm saying. Let's have a little nose. Oh, it smells nice. It really smells nice. You can smell, it still smells fairly young, but it's not as young as these ones. You know, some of the crap you get that smells like this mouthwash sort of stuff. So you're getting little notes, you're getting grainy notes, quite hefty grainy notes there. And I would imagine they would kind of mellow out a little bit, but you're also getting, oh, sort of a little background of bittersweet apples. It's kind of like those, almost a cooking apple sort of smell. You got some sort of nuts there, like a Brazil, no. Yeah, like a Brazil nut, walnut sort of thing, that sort of peanut, sort of husky, sort of the husks of the peanuts that smell you when you open a bag of monkey nuts. Grape pips, you know, when you crunch into a grape pip sometimes. And a little bit of kind of a dry white wine sort of smell in there. Like a Chardonnay sort of background. That apple's becoming stronger now as it's opening up. That apple note is becoming stronger. Apple cores, apple skins, kind of the tannins on the apples. That smells really cute. That smells really lovely. Oh, look at that. Look at the alcohol legs on there. You got them? Wait a minute. No, you ain't. Pretty little thing, it's all so pretty. Right, let's get down. Slungy, cheers, Nostrovia, whatever else. What's it in Japanese? A lot of whiskey goes in Japan, innit? You get a lot of whiskey out there. Anyway, cheers. Getting different circles on the tongue. Yeah, let's just move the water back there. Different little circles on the tongue. You're getting a little hint of spice. All fizzling around the tip of the tongue. You move back, you've got kind of vanilla, oaky sort of notes there. they're not massive. They're kind of one of these light sort of, almost a light wood, almost a, like a sucking a lolly stick sort of thing. You know, if you sucked a lolly stick when you were a kid until it's gone, like there's no taste left in it, and you're sort of chewing at it and all sorts. That kind of light, I don't know what they use for lolly sticks, but it's some sort of light wood. It's kind of not a flavoured, like, not big oaky sort of character. That's pretty. It's like cashew in there as well. Oh, that's handsome. Oh, that is handsome. That's nice. That's it's only what are we talking here? That's 12-year-old. And that's quite a little lovely little thing. That's really nice. Yeah, I think you're gonna enjoy that. Give that a go. That's the see, I was showing you the little one. I'll probably show you up here, I'll show you a picture of the big one. If I remember, hopefully I will. That is the 12-year-old, the little one there. That's kind of what it looked like there. The Glenfiddich. The reason we've got a little chap here, a little deer. It's kind of the Glen. It's like a little valley, a little between the mountains and whatever. And Glenfiddich is a valley of the deer. Deer valley, or valley of the deer. So it's it says on there valley of the deer as well. Distilled and matured in the valley of the deer. Sounds like a film, doesn't it? Planet of the Apes in the valley of the deer. Right, that is absolutely lovely. A bit of Glenfiddich. I really enjoyed that. I kind of have always thought, no, believe it or not, I've not had a Glenfiddich before, and I always thought, if I'm going to buy the mass-produced stuff, I'll just buy the cheaper sort of, you know, the all the kind of you, I ain't going to mention the brand names in it, but all the kind of the cheaper run-of-the-mill stuff, you know, you kind of whop it down and wee, lovely. But that is very fine and lovely. That really is. So, buy it, try it and like it. Without a doubt, absolutely lovely. Right, on to the 15, I think, now. I'll see you in the next one. Cheerio, chin chin, bottoms up. Cheers.